Mia went to the arcade with 45 tickets. She won 26 more tickets. Then, she spent 36 tickets to get a prize. How many tickets does Mia have left?
Welcome back! We've made it to our final quest in level 2. This time, we have a problem with lots of words. We don't always see that in math. It even tells us a little story. These are called word problems or story problems. Hidden inside is a math problem, and it's our job to figure out which operation we need to use to solve it. Let's get to work. Let's begin with this story problem. It says, Ava baked 19 cupcakes in the morning and 24 more cupcakes in the afternoon. How many cupcakes did Ava bake in all? Where should we start? First, let's circle the numbers we're working with. 19 and 24. Got it. Next, let's underline the question so we know exactly what we're trying to find. The question asks, how many cupcakes did Ava bake in all? Let's close our eyes and picture this story. In the morning, Ava bakes 19 cupcakes. Then, in the afternoon, she bakes 24 more. Did the number of cupcakes go up or down? She baked more, so the total number is growing or getting bigger. I got it. This means we can add to find out how many cupcakes she baked in all. All right, we have our numbers and we know our operation is addition. Let's write the addition problem vertically to represent the story. Perfect, we're ready to add. 9 plus 4 equals 13. We can write our 3 under the ones place and take the 10 next door. 1 plus 1 equals 2 plus 2 more equals 4. So our sum is 43. Hold on. 43 what? Imagine someone says, there's 43. You'd probably ask, 43 what? 43 puppies? 43 people? $43? The list could go on and on. That's why in word problems, we always need to label our answers with a unit, a word that tells us what the number is counting. In this problem, we're counting cupcakes. So instead of just writing 43, we'll write 43 cupcakes. Grab your pencil and try the next one with me in your guided notes. Our next problem says, Liam had $56 saved up. He spent $32 on a new toy robot. How much money does Liam have left? Take a second to circle the numbers we're working with in your guided notes. 56 and 32. Perfect. Now let's underline the question and think about what's happening in the story. Our question is, how much money does Liam have left? Let's picture Liam's savings jar. Liam's jar has $56 inside. He's been saving up for a while. Now Liam goes to the store to buy a robot. He finds the perfect one and takes $32 out of his jar to pay for it. What happened to the amount of money in Liam's jar? He gave money to the cashier to pay for the robot. Does that mean Liam will have more money than he started with or less? Right. When he gave money to the cashier, that money was being taken away or subtracted. We found our operation. Let's solve to figure out how much is left in his jar. We know that when we subtract, we always start with the greater number. In this problem, that would be 56. So that will go at the top of our problem written vertically. Okay, let's subtract. 6 minus 2. We have more on top, so there's no need to stop and regroup. 6 minus 2 equals 4, and 5 minus 3 equals 2. Our answer is 24, but let's not forget our label, or unit. What are we counting in this problem? Dollars. $24. Okay, we've solved a story problem with both addition and subtraction. I think we're ready to take a look at our quest. Our quest says, Mia went to the arcade with 45 tickets. She won 26 more tickets. Then she spent 36 tickets to get a prize. How many tickets does Mia have left? Let's circle our numbers. 45, 26, and 36? Wait a minute. This problem has three numbers. It looks like there's going to be more than one step to solve this. Let's act this out right here at the arcade, breaking it down one part at a time. Mia has 45 tickets. Then she won 26 more. If we win tickets, does that add to our total or take away from our total? You got it. When we win tickets, we add to our total number of tickets. Now Mia has 45 plus 26 more. Let's add that up. 5 plus 6 equals 11. We'll write our 1 here and then carry the other 1 next door to regroup. 4 plus 1 equals 5, plus 2 more equals 7. So Mia has 71 tickets after winning more. We've used our first two numbers, but we still have one more number to use. The next part says she spent tickets for a prize. This is just like our last problem where Liam spent his money. What operation should we use here? Right. Mia goes to the prize booth with her 71 tickets. She gives them 36 tickets in exchange for a prize. That means her total goes down, or she has less. So now we need to subtract 36 from her total of 71. We have more on the floor here, so we need to go next door and get 10 more. This 7 will become a 6, and we can add the 10 here, giving us 11. Now we can subtract. 11 minus 6 equals 5, and 6 minus 3 equals 3. Our final answer is 35 tickets. First, we added the tickets Mia won. Then we subtracted the ones she spent. That's a two-step word problem. Write our final answer on your math quest while I input our answer. We did it! We completed level 2 and learned how to solve story problems, even tricky ones with two steps. Now it's time to level up. On to level 3 we go. Remember, every problem has a solution, and we've got the skills to solve it. See you next time. Hey.